Hey everyone, in this video, I'll be reviewing this DC circuit breaker disconnect switch, which are commonly installed to protect electrical wiring in solar systems. Another purpose of this breaker is to allow you to manually disconnect the panels from your charge controller and auxiliary arrays from when you want to conduct routine maintenance or troubleshoot problems in your solar system. In this video, we're going to do a product unboxing and show you the important details of this product, and finally teach you how to attach electrical wires to this product. Let's get into the details. This is what the product box looks like when you first get it. Nothing fancy and not much product information. Inside the box, you have two mounting screws, the main breaker component, and a DIN rail mount, but no user manual. To install this breaker, you'll want to mount the DIN rail to the wall with these two screws. Once it's installed, you want to insert the bottom part of this fuse to the DIN rail and then push down to install the DIN rail to the fuse. Pretty easy. If you're sizing a breaker for a solar system, you'll need to calculate the total potential current output of your solar system by referring to your panel's short circuit current rating and multiplying this amount by 1.56, then round up to get your breaker rating. Specifically in my hand is the 40 amp rated breaker, and you can see this in the front where it says C40. This breaker is designed to switch off once the rated current is reached. When that happens, this switch will flip down, breaking the circuit and stopping the flow of power. You can also do this intentionally when you want to work on your system. To reestablish the circuit, you simply push the switch back into the on position. Now, let's connect some wires to this breaker. For wires coming from the power source, like your solar panels, you'll need to connect the positive and negative wires, aka the red and the black wire, to the top of this breaker. Here, where you can see the minus and the plus symbols. And at the bottom of this breaker is where you'll insert the wire that goes to your loads and auxiliary batteries. It's super important to make sure you don't get this backwards. The top of the breaker goes to your power source, like your solar panels, and the bottom goes to the loads and batteries. If you get this backwards, you can potentially start a serious fire. In this example, I'll be using this 10 gauge wire to connect to the top of the breaker, but you can install anywhere from a 14 to 8 gauge wire. First, make sure that the switch is in the off position. Then insert the black wire into the correct slot and tighten down with a screwdriver. When you're done, do the same with your positive red wire. And when you're done with that, you can do the same for the wires coming out of the bottom of the breaker. And that's about it. Our only criticism of this product is that it doesn't come with any user manual for more specific installation information. You can find basic info printed on the breaker on the sides and the front, but if you're looking for something more detailed, you'll have to go online to find it. Thanks for watching. Building an electrical system in a camper van can be complicated. Just look at all the products that you'll need. That's why we provide an electrical wiring ebook filled with simple, intuitive wiring diagrams and product and tool recommendations to help you build your system as fast as possible. To access this free ebook, click the link in the description below or head over to our website's homepage. Happy building!